Pregnant women, now part of the Philippines' priority list for COVID jabs. They will be included in the A3 priority group along with individuals with comorbidities. The health department says COVID vaccines are generally safe for pregnant women and actively recommends it for those in their second and third trimester. All COVID shots with emergency use authorization in the Philippines, except for Sputnik V, may be administered on pregnant women.
Pwedeng bigyan ng muna para sa mga high-risk pregnant women during the first trimester, no? Kung meron shared decision. May medical clearance sa gitna ng medical ng pregnant na pasyente at saka yung kanyang attending OBGYN.
This comes after the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention advised pregnant women to get vaccinated. The CDC cited a new study that shows COVID jabs do not increase the risk of miscarriage. It adds the risk of getting a severe case of COVID-19 becomes higher during pregnancy, while coronavirus infections increase the risk for preterm birth.
The Philippines receives 2 million more doses of Sinovac's COVID vaccine. The government procured doses arrived in the country Thursday evening. Vaccine czar Carlito Galvez Jr. says a million of these jabs will be allocated to the National Capital Region and other key urban areas, while the remaining half will go to various provinces. 4 million additional Sinovac doses, along with 1 million Sinopharm shots, are expected to arrive in the country next week. The Philippines has administered more than 26 million vaccine shots as of August 11, including over 12 million second doses. Filipino authorities are investigating how a man fully vaccinated for COVID in May was still able to get a booster shot this week. The man claimed on social media that he was given a Moderna jab in Quezon City. He says this followed the 2 Sinovac doses he got in Mandaluyong City. Quezon City officials now planning to file charges against him. Booster COVID shots are still prohibited in the country.
Huwag po tayo magtangkang gawin po ito. Maawa naman po tayo sa mga taong hindi pa nababakunahan. E kailangan naman ireserba naman po natin to, dahil syempre meron nga tayong Delta variant at alam po lahat ng tao ay takot na po dito. E prioritize po natin yung mga priority sectors na hindi pa nababakunahan.
The Philippine Quarantine Bureau says its international vaccination card can be presented by Filipino migrant workers entering Hong Kong instead of the cards issued by local government units. The so-called yellow card is given to travelers going to countries that require proof of vaccination. Several Hong Kong-bound overseas Filipino workers were stranded in Manila after Hong Kong refused to recognize the COVID vaccination cards issued by various LGUs. The Quarantine Bureau says applications for the yellow card can be done through its online booking system and through its satellite offices.
Yellow card po or ICB ay hindi po mandatory at hindi po ito matuturing na immunity passport. Ito po ay nagsisilbi lang po na proof of vaccination ng isang individual. So hindi po lahat ng pupunta sa ibang bansa kailangan ng ICB. Ang kailangan lang po ng mga pupunta sa ibang bansa makipag-ugnayan doon po sa mga health ministry po kung saan sila pupunta, kung ano po yung mga requirements, na requirements na kailangan nila para makapasok sa bansa nila.
The Philippines' COVID-19 case tally breaches 1.7 million. That's after the health department logged 12,439 new infections Thursday, the highest in over 4 months. It's also the second straight day daily cases exceeded 12,000. 165 additional deaths were also reported. Active infections now stand at over 87,000. Meanwhile, the country's intensive care capacity nearing high risk at 69%.
Health officials confirm 177 more Delta variant cases, bringing the total to 627. One of the patients has died while most have already recovered. Majority of the samples came from the National Capital Region. There were also Delta carriers found in other regions such as Calabarzon, Cagayan Valley, Western Visayas, and Davao. Health Undersecretary Rosario Vergere has said the highly contagious Delta variant may push daily COVID-19 cases to 15,000 within the week.
Over 3 billion pesos in national government aid are allotted for 2 Philippine provinces under the country's strictest quarantine status. The budget department says 2.7 billion pesos will be given to Laguna while Bataan will receive 700 million pesos. An additional allocation of 368 million pesos will be given to Metro Manila's local governments. Some of them earlier claimed the funds downloaded to them last week cannot cover all the low-income families who received aid in last April's lockdown.